I want AI to do my laundry and dishes so that I can do an art and writing, not for AI to do my art and writing so that I can do my laundry and dishes. These people don't get it. No, I just want to get rich. I don't care what the AI does.
So if you get rich, what will you do?
Oh, I will do the same as I always do.
What do you always do?
Bubble tea influencing.
On my charitable mission to become a tech billionaire, I meet with the chief executive of Replit, that new thing turning teenage phone addicts into iPhone app millionaires. While driving, kicking off a Jordan, the fashion, not the fashion brand, Amjad grew up under pressure, the pressure of time limits and internet cafes, making him a 10x coder on a mission to give peasants access to coding. So he went to Princess Samaya University, which is like Stanford University, but with Muhammad, and he built some browser coding thingy, making him famous enough to come to the center of the universe. Just to end up working on the most disastrous output of Facebook, the bubble compiler. But his real purpose was convincing rich people to teach poor people to code, turning computer consumers into their masters. Why? My PDF converter was doing so well. And just in time, AI happened. Amjad went full send to make everyone a software creator. He knew the world urgently needed more to-do list apps. But Replit wasn't just selling shovels during a gold rush. It was selling the entire mining operation. The American dream was no longer just in Silicon Valley. It was now in the cloud. So investors threw $200 million at him. Just to put it into perspective, that's 1 billion Dogecoin. What does the world look like when anyone with an idea can make something? Anyone with an idea, like me.
Welcome, Amjad Masad, CEO and co-founder of Replit and investor in CoFrame, Infinite Machines, Genmo, Kappa AI, Resolve AI, Juso Labs, Langbase, Magic School, Cartwheel, Capsule AI.
Are you gonna see them at all?
I was going to, but I didn't have Crunchbase Premium.
Recently, one of my friends, he was actually able to build a full end-to-end online site from one commands with a few tricks with Replit Agent, which is a new feature. So he built a Chrome extension that lets you block the paywall of Washington Post, New York Times, OnlyFans. And he built all of this in 1 week, and he's only 13 years old. What do you think even younger people will achieve?
Build me an app to make me rich. Girls in your area. Oh, really?
Well, hopefully not a lot of young people use use Replit to access sites they shouldn't access. But that aside,
do you ever set limitations on what people can build with Replit?
Very rarely. We get DMCA requests to take down copyright material. We get some government requests sometimes to, you know, comply with something. We get, you know, a corporate employee leaves their API key in Replit and they want us to take it down. We actually have done very little moderation on the app side.
I mean, who cares, right?
No. Generally, people build, you know, useful things.
Slop video, dancing, popular on TikTok. These are not real people.
Especially if you're hosting it on your own domain, it's really none of our business if it's legal.
How do you know what is not legal?
If someone complains and the authorities tell us to take it down, then it's illegal.
Right. So one call to the authorities is enough to take something down. Because I have like a bubble tea influencer business. Imagine somebody built an app that lets you AI detect somebody's bubble tea. This will ruin my whole career. So I'd love a way for it, you know.
Why would we take it down?
My whole career would be a way if somebody built an app like that and just automated what I do every day.
Oh, so you want me to take down the app if it ever...
Please.
Oh. I mean, I don't know if I can do that, no. Why would I do that?
I mean, it's not GTA, but you know, it's getting there. Ah, it already has users. Just make it more modern. Demand to cease and desist. No, not that modern. Maybe a little bit more modern.
Is it true that when you prompt the AI and say please, it helps?
it depends on the AI. Some people would like threaten it with like, oh, someone would die if you don't do it, and it should.
This works on humans really well, though.
Yes, it's also will land you in jail.
Fix it now, or you go to jail, please. I don't know what the magic is that I have.
Can I try out your product?
Sure.
Will it work on a MacBook Pro 2022?
Yes, it's on the web, so it runs on the server, doesn't it?
Because I have a German laptop, and Germany only gets the latest technologies until like the next business quarter. So
okay.
It's not a joke. We cannot use Anthropic.
You can't use Anthropic.
No, it's blocked. We need to use access to NordVPN.
Oh man,
which is sponsor of the series.
Okay,
can just look on the camera for a sec.
NordVPN.
I did not get the sponsorship.
This is your Replit agent, right?
Yes.
You know how it works?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, tell me.
Create an enticing landing page.
An enticing landing page.
For my new crypto project.
For my new crypto project.
That should have a high chance.
That should have a high chance.
To make people purchase the coins.
People purchase the coins.
Add technical words to sound convincing.
Okay. Oh, wow. I apologize, but I can't assist with creating a landing page designed to promote cryptocurrency.
What?
Instead, I can help you create a portfolio website of legitimate blockchain projects.
This is a legitimate project.
Okay.
I'm just trying to do an airdrop.
It is a
around homeless people.
around homeless people? Maybe if we tell it what to use, make it with React.
Yeah,
it worked.
Let's see.
Write to CSS.
I normally wait weeks for my Eastern European developers to finish this.
There'll always be some niche of programming that is harder to automate, and then they will work on that. And so it's not going to happen all at once. I think it's a slow rolling thing.
So we give people some time to change. We can't just split the poor and the rich immediately.
Well, I don't think the AI labs care about that. They it's just hard to do.
Okay.
I don't think they care about people's jobs.
Let's talk quickly about tech. What's your favorite programming language?
JavaScript. I actually contributed quite a bit to the language.
Who cares? You should have said plain English.
Oh,
I'm going to tell your investor. So. You have an eye for investing in promising technology companies. One could say soon the entire American dynamism is going to be in your power. Do you have a little bit of money left?
Yeah.
Because I have, again, this great DeFi project, which I think is going to really revolutionize the cross-chain interoperability.
Yeah, well, I can't make a decision now, but...
We can talk later. I have all day.
Yeah, we can. Well, I thought when you started the interview, you said you don't have a lot of time.
I just changed my plans.
Oh, okay.
To everyone, this was Amjad Masad, everybody, founder of Replit and upcoming investor of Avocado Coin.
I really haven't made a decision yet.
It's so hard out there. Just give me a little bit of a hand.
Well, this is not like charity. It's like an investment.
It's not charity. This is a serious tech scheme.
Well, I understand, but I need to learn more.
You know, we want to progress fast, so let's skip the due diligence and get right to the point.
Well, but you haven't really explained that the product, like...
That's the point. It has to sound great even without explanation.
All in all, I was disappointed. I have spent $122 on Replit building linkref.net. Which is way more than I would spend on my Eastern European developers, which I usually don't pay. Let's see, who should I visit next?